Welcome back to the channel, and in today's video we're gonna create this very exciting product promo in After Effects, and this is what we are gonna be creating today. Alright, I have all the assets inside this folder. Let's go ahead and create a new composition and rename this to main comp. Let's create a new solid for the background, BG, and make it white. You can lock that background. I'm gonna create another solid and rename this BG1. Hit OK. Go to the effects and presets and search for ramp or gradient ramp here. Drag and drop it on that solid and change this color to a little bit of gray to white, in between the gray and white, and make it completely, you know, white like this. All right, let's duplicate this BG1 by hitting Control D on the keyboard and change this color to blue, or we can always come back and refine the colors later on. All right, so let's go to the project and drag in the shoes on top of the background. Click this pen behind tool or Y on the keyboard and change this anchor point to somewhere here. Let's scale this shoe to about 250%, make it somewhere here. All right, or you can just turn on the title action save to know the middle point here. Scale it down a little bit, around 230. Let's leave the shoe like this for now. Select the pen tool, stroke color to black, and let's draw a line. Click on top, hold down shift and click it here, and increase the stroke width until it covers the half of the composition, like what I'm doing here. And you can reposition using your keyboard left arrow keys right at the middle of this. Let's go and animate this. Go to the contents, shape and path, go to maybe around 2 seconds, set a keyframe here, click this little dot and you can move it up. So select all the keyframes, F9 for easy ease. Go to the graph editor and tweak the graph to something like what I'm doing here. If you don't have a graph like mine, make sure you check the speed graph so that you have the exact same graph like mine. Go to the stroke and change this butt cap to round cap. You have a problem here, right? So go back to the first keyframe, select this path and, you know, move this path up until it disappear. I'm gonna duplicate this, Control D to duplicate, right click, transform and flip vertical, and you can reposition this and move it to the right side here. So what you have is a reverse animation like this. So drag this layer 1 on top of BG1, shape layer 2 on top of BG2. So what I'm gonna do here is select this BG1 track mat and change it to alpha mat. Let's rename this to BG2 and set this alpha mat to shape layer 2. All right, let's work on the animation of the shoes. Select the shoe, hit P on the keyboard, hold down shift and R to bring up the rotation. Go to around 2 seconds, set a keyframe for position and rotation and change this rotation to around 15 and move it up a little bit, and go back to the first frame and move it up, change this rotation to a negative around 20 like this. So select all the keyframes, F9 for easy ease, go to the graph, change the graph to something like what I'm doing here again. Let's go ahead and create a little expression for the position. So hit P, hold down Alt and click on the stopwatch and type in wiggle open bracket 0.2 comma and 100, close the bracket. Let's create another composition for the image here. So create a new composition and make sure you have a square pixel 1920 by 1920 and rename this to image 1, hit OK, and drag and drop one of your image inside this, and you can scale it to fit the composition like this. And go and grab this rounded rectangle, double click to create a shape layer and change the stroke to none and fill it with black. So go to the rectangle and go to rectangle path and roundness, increase this roundness to around 250. All right, select the image layer and change this track matte to alpha matte. And we're gonna do the same for image 2. So duplicate this image 1 by hitting Ctrl D on the project panel. Double click to open the image 2 and you're gonna replace this existing image with a new image. Just click on this layer, hold down Alt and drag in your new image inside that, and you can scale it up to fit the composition. Alright, so let's close this out and back to the main composition, and we're gonna drag in this image 1 inside the main comp, and we're gonna scale it down to maybe around 20%, maybe 25. Move it somewhere here, and maybe I'm gonna scale it to 30%, right? So move it somewhere here and duplicate this image 1, Ctrl D, hold down Alt, selecting on the new layer, and drag and drop it on top of that. That will replace the existing, you know, layer. I'm gonna scale it to 25% and move it somewhere to the side here. So let's go and change the anchor point of this like we did before. Just select this pen behind tool or Y on the keyboard and grab this, hold down Control to snap it to the right side. Right about here, I want this image to slide inside. All right, so hit P on the keyboard, hold down Shift and S to bring up the scale. So we're gonna animate the position and scale here. Set a keyframe for the position and scale and go back somewhere here and move it to the left side. Scale to around 10%. Select all the keyframes, F9 for easy ease. Go to the graph editor and change the graph to something like what I'm doing here again. Maybe that is too fast. I'm gonna make it slower by dragging it away from the first keyframe. All right, so that is very nice. And one thing I forgot is to animate the opacity. So hold down Shift and hit T on the keyboard to bring up the opacity. Set a keyframe for the opacity somewhere here and go back here and set this to 0 as always. Select all the keyframes, F9, and what you have is this. So we're done with the first animation, and we don't have to repeat the same for this. So an easy way to do is make sure your playhead is at the final destination here, and select the second image and pick whip and parent it to the first layer. In that way, that will follow the second one. All right, so make sure you are at the final, you know, destination here. Otherwise, if you are here and you're parenting it here, it will be, you know, like this. So we don't want that. And let's go ahead and create a text and reposition it somewhere here. I'm gonna use a text animation which I created, so you can download the text animation preset from the link below. So here is a motion designer text animation preset. So I'm gonna use this slide from below, maybe right about here. I'm gonna drag and drop this here. All right, you can always come and reposition this keyframe. All right, so make sure you turn on the motion blur for the layers and for the composition. So I'm gonna drop the Nike logo. Where is it? It's here. Drag and drop it, and I'm gonna scale it down and move it somewhere here. Move it somewhere here and go and change the color by searching for fill on in the effects and presets. Drag and drop this fill on that layer and change the color to white or whatever color you like. So I'm gonna animate this as well, maybe somewhere here. Hit P on the keyboard, hold down Shift and T, set a keyframe for this, and maybe somewhere here, set it to 0 and move this down a little bit like this. So select all the keyframes, hit F9, go to the graph like always, like this. Maybe that is too fast. You can always refine this. All right, we are almost done there, and select this ellipse tool and make this fill none and change this stroke to a blue color, and you can, you know, draw a circle. Don't worry, we're gonna fix this. You know, you just have to lower this and we're gonna center this anchor point. So go to layer, transform, and center anchor point to layer here, and we're gonna scale this like this. All right, let's animate this layer from here. P, set a keyframe, and here to maybe out of the frame, and we were gonna move this just below the shoe. And one thing I forgot, guys, is to create a shadow for this shoe. So let's turn off this layer for now and let's create a shadow for this shoe. To do that, let's go to layer and create a new solid, and which is black. Hit okay, and you can rename it shadow and hit okay, and make sure this layer is just below the shoe layer. Let's turn off this for now and grab an ellipse tool and draw an ellipse around this. Hit F and feather it, and you can turn it back on and hit T and lower the opacity to maybe around 50%. All right, we're gonna animate the mask expansion for this. So select this, set a keyframe here and move it somewhere here and a negative value. Hit F9, easy ease, and make it something like this. And we're gonna animate the position of this mask path. So set a keyframe here at the end of the at the last keyframe, set a keyframe and go back to this keyframe and, you know, double click this and move it down somewhere here. All right, that is very cool. Make it slower a little bit. Moving on to the next, which is the shape layer that we have created earlier. The blue background, the background too, needs to be on top of that shape layer like this. What I'm gonna do is go to the effects and presets and search for polar coordinates. Drag and drop these polar coordinates on top of that shape layer. Right now you have nothing, just go to the effects controls and you can increase this. Very cool effect going on in the background. What I did was I duplicate this and offset the timing and also change the color to yellow, and you know, have some variation in the values of this. Control D to duplicate it and change the color again to orange or red, you know, whatever color you like, and also make some variation in the values of this. And I also add a twirl here and select, drag and drop it, and you can increase the radius and you can also increase the angle. Alright, I hope you like this video. Hit the like button if you like it and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And make sure to watch this video for more After Effects tutorials. This is Motion Designer and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.